In this video, I'll introduce the valence bond theory and what that tells us about the bonding of a molecule, of the atoms in a molecule. So the valence bond theory, two things you want to think about. You want to consider the overlapping of the atomic orbitals. And that is, we know that in a covalent bond, we have shared electrons. So there will be some overlapping of the orbitals. The other thing that the valence bond considers, which the Lewis structure, for example, does not consider, is the potential energy changes in a molecule as the atoms get closer or farther apart. So potential energy. And that's really a big deal in the valence bond theory. The potential energy. So let's look at an example, the hydrogen gas molecule. We know that that's going to give a Lewis structure that looks just like this, H bond H. But what about this? How strong is that bond? We don't know from the Lewis structure. And the Lewis structure is fantastic. I'm not trying to badmouth the Lewis structure because it's brilliant. But we go a little bit further, as we keep on doing with any subject. We say, well, what about the bond strength? How strong is this bond? Well, it depends on how close the hydrogen atoms are to each other. And we want to reach a most stable bond. And we will see that we reach a most stable bond when the hydrogen atoms are a specific distance apart from each other. And it turns out, let me just give you the punchline right now. It turns out that that is when the distance between these two is 74 picometers. That's when you have a most stable hydrogen bond or a hydrogen gas molecule. Now, what happens? What happens as they go from being far apart to being close together? Let's look at this graph. We've got potential energy on the y-axis. Up here it's positive. That is, up here it's positive. Down here it's negative. We've got zero right here. And what does it look like when the hydrogen atoms are far apart from each other, like this? They're far apart from each other. Well, the potential energy, and this is, I should label this distance apart. This is a distance apart from the, between the atoms. The potential energy is basically zero. That is, it would take just about zero energy to get these atoms even farther apart from each other. Now, as these atoms get closer to each other, like this, the potential energy begins to decline. So think of it like two people dancing at a prom dance. Right? In eighth grade, they step far apart. It's not too hard for the teachers to tear them apart. They get a little bit closer, and their potential energy becomes negative, meaning that you would have to add energy to that system, to that mix, in order to separate them. Now, you get to a state where finally their atomic orbitals are overlapping, and this is this point, when they are overlapping to a significant point where we have a most stable molecule. And that is when the distance between the nuclei is 74 picometers. That's specific for the hydrogen molecule. So again, lowest potential energy, that means that you would have to add a great amount of energy to separate those. Whereas here, you would not have to add as much energy to separate those. Now, what happens when these get even closer and closer? Well, if you start getting crazy and just putting these two right on top of each other like that, these two atoms, well, then the potential energy is going to shoot up. And why is that? Well, it's because the nuclei start to repel each other, and so it doesn't take a lot of energy to push those apart there. So this is what's happening. Let's just review this again. Far apart, the hydrogen atoms are far apart. You have basically zero potential energy. It doesn't take a lot of energy to push those farther apart. And then the valence bond theory says, well, what happens when these orbital shells get closer to each other? Well, we've got a little bit stronger bond, and that is more negative potential energy. It would take more energy to pull these apart. And then we get at some most stable point, and that is for the hydrogen molecule, specifically 74 picometers. And that is where it would take the most energy among all of these examples, the most energy to pull those atoms apart. If they get too close together, then they're going to naturally want to push away from each other, and so the potential energy would go positive then. Now, the reason this is important is because, again, this model does not show how strong this bond is, but guess what? Now that you understand valence bond theory, just a little bit of it, an introduction of it, maybe you can come up with a new model. We've got the Lewis structure, and we've got valence bond theory. What about coming up with a new one? Some hybrid of, not to be confused with hybridization, but some hybrid of the Lewis structure and the valence bond theory, where you say, I'm going to make this line thicker if the bond is stronger. Or thinner if the bond is weaker. Now that's of course not what valence bond theory does, but what I'm exploring is ideas that you can use, that you can do with this, because as with any subject, and specifically chemistry and in the sciences, we keep getting better and better at our metaphors, our analogies for explaining what is actually going on between the atoms in our world. Now, I hope that was helpful. If you found that helpful, please consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.